Welcome, friends. Welcome back to the kitchen. This is a recipe that I hadn't planned on doing when I woke up this morning. I am making syrup for cherry pop. So I have some cherries that are left over. I've got the syrup that's dripping out. And what I did with these cherries was I vacuum sealed them with some sugar, vanilla pod, and some black peppercorns. And then I sous vide for a few hours and then left them for about a day and a half or 2 days to fully macerate and extract the juice. And this is the juice, and I'm filtering it through a coffee filter to get all the fine particles out. But I've been left with these cherries. This cherry pulp still has an incredible amount of flavor. So I thought, let's do an upside down cherry cake, or a cherry upside down cake. So I have a baking pan that I have buttered, and I've made myself a little parchment disc. And so I'll put the parchment disc in the bottom of the cake pan, and I have a video about making a parchment disc if you really want to find out how to do it. Next in, I'm going to put some butter. And then the cherries. Now, you don't need these macerated cherries. I'm just doing this to use up something that otherwise would be thrown out. And I didn't want to do that because there's so much flavor left in them. But if you're just using cherries straight out of the freezer, you don't even have to thaw them. You could put them in the bottom just like I have. I would put in a couple tablespoons of sugar at this point, sprinkle the sugar on top. Now I'm going to put these in the oven and bake them at 450 degrees Fahrenheit for about 35 or 40 minutes, and you want to sort of caramelize all of those sugars before you put the cake in. Moving on to the cake, it's pretty standard. In goes some butter, and we start creaming that together. Once the butter's softened up and is starting to get a little bit fluffy, in goes the sugar. And we just let that keep creaming until it's nice, light, and fluffy. So into this flour, I'm gonna put some salt, some baking soda, and some baking powder. And just give that a little bit of a stir to bring it all together. Once the butter and sugar is creamed together really nicely, we'll add the eggs one by one. And don't cut short this creaming step. It's one of those steps that a lot of people don't spend enough time on. I'm one of those people. I often cut it short, and I should let it go longer. The longer you let it go, the better your cake is going to be. So, eggs in one at a time. And people always ask me one at a time. They just incorporate better if you do it one at a time and then wait before you put the next one in. It actually mixes faster this way. Okay, that's looking good. We've got our dry ingredients ready to go. Now we need to put in some, I'm using plain yogurt. You could use sour cream if you wanted. You could use buttermilk if you wanted. There are a lot of options. What you're looking for is sour and acidity. And the two best choices would be yogurt and or sour cream. So we need about a cup of that. Now, people often ask me about using the stand mixer. I kind of use it because it speeds up my day here in the studio. Makes doing, you know, two or three recipes over the course of a day so much easier. If you're doing it at home, you don't need one. You could do it with a hand beater. You could do it with a wooden spoon. Those are all options. One of the things I will say, though, is in older cookbooks, this is a cookbook from 1899, and when you look at the recipes in that cookbook, most of the cakes, it tells you to beat the batter for 45 minutes to an hour and a half. So mixing is super important, and if this sort of speeds that along, so I'm not standing here with a wooden spoon for an hour, I think it's well worth it. Now the plan is a little bit of the yogurt and then a little bit of the flour and just go back and forth between the two, a little bit at a time. Now here's the pan with the cherries in the bottom, which is the top, and in goes the batter. Now it doesn't matter if the cherries are still hot, they can be hot, they can be cold. You do have to change the temperature of the oven between cooking the cherries and the cake. So more than likely, they will have cooled a bit while you're waiting. And you want to push the cake into the corners and smooth the top a little bit. And then into the oven.
Ooh, look at that.
That's a good looking cake. I'm gonna come on this side.
Okay, so it's
thank you.
It's not the most exciting cake on its own, but the cherries are going to make it amazing, I think. Although it's a great looking cake. It's got good loft.
It's a nice white cake.
Yeah. I really just want the topping. Yeah, that's amazing.
It's a lovely cake.
Yeah.
Cherries are great. Who doesn't like sweet cherries?
Well, and the cherries are something that, you know, after I made the pop, check out the video elsewhere on the channel, would have just been thrown away, but they still had so much flavor in them. And they were flavored with vanilla and black peppercorns.
Which is great.
And when I first took a spoonful of the cherries in the sieve after I had strained off the juice, I got one of the peppercorns. And I got to tell you, it wasn't hot. It just tasted amazing, and it added such a depth of flavor that I think now anytime I do cherries, I'm going to put black pepper in them. And I have to thank one of our commenters for telling us about his grandmother, who always won at the county fair with her cherry pie because she put pepper in it.
I love that kind of traditional knowledge that is just in someone's head.
You know, not written down. I personally have not come across cherry recipes with pepper in it. So that is a great tip, and I thank you for that. You can put any fruit on this you want. You know?
Whatever you got.
Any upside down cake. This cake, even on its own, even though it's an unflavored cake, on its own, it would be really good. The yogurt or sour cream, whichever one you decide to use, adds so much to it. So, we've got a big cake to eat. We've also got a baked pasta to eat. I think I'm going to finish this piece of cake first. Thanks for stopping by. See you again soon.